السلام عليك يا وارث أمير المؤمنين ولي الله.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وفوض أمري إلى الله إن الله بصير بالعباد، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، والجنة للمؤمنين، والنار للكافرين، والصلاة والسلام على أكرم الأنبياء والمرسلين، شفيع المذنبين، خاتم النبيين، رحمة للعالمين، بالقاسم محمد. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد، وعجل فرجهم وأهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين، لا سيما بقية الله في الأرضين، صاحب العصر والزمان، خليفة الرحمن، إمام الإنس والجان، الذي بيمنه رزق الورى وبه طبتت الأرض والسماء. اللهم عجل فرجه الشريف. أما بعد، فقد قال الله وهو أصدق القائلين وقوله الحق. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الله ولي الذين آمنوا يخرجهم من الظلمات إلى النور، والذين كفروا أولياءهم الطاغوت يخرجونهم من النور إلى الظلمات، أولئك أصحاب النار هم فيها خالدون. I begin in the name of Allah, the gracious, the merciful. We are talking about the ziyarah, the very famous ziyarah of Imam Hussein alayhi salatu wasalam is called Ziyarat al-Warith. Warith is inheritance of the prophethood, which starts from Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alayka ya waritha Adama Safwatillah. Before we go further, I think it is better to understand the wilaya itself. Quran gives clear guidance for humanity in order to perceive the perspective of the materialistic world and the spiritual world. These are the two domains. In fact, there is only one domain, that is domain of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Innama waliyukum Allah. Your wali, your guardian is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then wa rasuluhu walladhina amanu walladhina yuqimuna salat wa yutuna zakat wa hum raki'un. In this ayah, this famous ayah in the ayatul kursi, it is famous with ayatul kursi, that is, it says Allahu waliyu alladhina amanu. Allah is wali for those who believe in, for the believers. What are their job? Allahu waliyu alladhina amanu yukhrijuhum min adh-dhulumati ila an-nur. Their job is to bring humanity from the darkness towards the light. This is also clear guidance for all of us. There has to have a system, an energy, positive energy, which brings humanity towards the perfect path, the path which leads to the light and the success of this world and also hereinafter. That wilaya has been given, that is the wilayatul takween. Wilayatul dhati belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Innama waliyukum Allah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself, he said, wa rasuluhu. That wilaya has been given in tashri' to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All the prophets, then it went to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. With the command of Allah, ya ayyuhar rasul, balligh ma unzila ilayka min rabbik. وَإِن لَمْ تَفْعَلْ فَمَا بَلَّغْتَ رِسَالَتَهُ. After the revelation of this ayah, Prophet Muhammad took the hands of Imam Ali in the presence of nearly more than 100,000 Hujjaj and Muslimin. He declared, مَنْ كُنْتُ مَوْلَى فَهَذَا عَلِيٌّ مَوْلَى. The guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should be till the day of judgment. إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ مُنْذِرْ وَلِكُلِّ قَوْمٍ هَادٍ. Quran says, O Prophet, you are the Munzir, you are the warner. For each and every community, there has to have a guide. That إِنَّ عَلَيْنَا لَلْهُدَى وَإِنَّ لَنَا لَلْآخِرَةُ وَالْأُولَى. Guidance comes from us. This guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there from beginning of the time till the last moment of the time, the beyond of the time also. That guidance belongs to Allah. وَمَنْ يَهْدِ اللَّهُ فَلَا مُضِلَّ لَهُ. The one who is guided by Allah, nobody can misguide. Once we understand this wilaya is a guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when the time came, the Islam has deviated from its path, one has to come up with this complete clear guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. after the demise of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, slowly the Muslim Ummah has deviated from the point of the wilaya. And if two parallel lines are going, if one line goes away from one point, even 1 centimeter, the more they go further, the distance will be further. That's why in order to rectify the problem, one has to go back to the point where we deviated. The point of deviation is the wilaya. And that's why Prophet says, those who have gone further, they have to come back in the plane of Ghadir. Those who have not yet come, they have to wait, because that is the point of the wilaya, where nobody should be misguided. Ya Ali, you are the guide. And whoever wants to be on right path, they have to follow. That's why Prophet Muhammad clearly said it. This is in the books of all Muslim Ummah. In Sahih Sitta is very famous hadith which says, Inni tarikum fikum athqalain kitab Allah wa itrati. I am leaving behind two weighty things. One is the Quran, the kitab of Allah, book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another, the interpreters are those who have capacity to explain and execute the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, laws of Quran, or Ahlul Bayt alayhi salatu wasalam. These parallel two things are together, and it will be together until ma in tamassaktum behima. As long as one is cling to these two, never going to go misguided. Lan tadillu badi. The moment if we move away from one of the two, it will be deviation from the path. So that is the point where Ummah has deviated. Imam Hussain has to take a drastic step to bring back the Ummah, the point of deviation. That's why in the ziyarat we recite, As-salamu alayka ya waritha Adam as-safwatillah, As-salamu alayka ya waritha Nuh al-Nabiyillah, As-salamu alayka ya waritha Ibrahim khalilillah. Viratha is heir of Adam, heir of Nuh, heir of all of these virasa come in the hands of Imam Hussain. So Imam Hussain is not a person, is the heir of the virasa of the prophets. And this scheme is a challenge. That's why before he moving from Medina, he declared, إِنَّمَا خَرَجْتُ لِتَلَبِ الْإِصْلَاحِ فِي أُمَّةِ جَدِّي. Why I'm going? He has given clear manifesto of Karbala. I'm not going for any mischief there. That's why he took very few people, and he took in a place where it's not inhabitants. No one were there. It's not, there was not a city so that people can accuse him of the facade. He went to plain of Karbala. There the army of Yazid came, the confrontation came. That's why we believe that if Karbala wouldn't have been there, the entire system of Islam would have been collapsed. And this has been prophesized by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, by Imam Ali, by Imam Hassan, and also Imam Hussein himself. Karbala is not an event, it is a moment. Inna lil Husayn harara fi qulubil mu'minin. For Imam Hussein, there is a harara, there is a warmth, because Imam Hussein stood for the truth. So when he reaches the wilaya of As-salamu alayka ya waritha Amir al-Mu'minina Waliyillah. So this is very important for all of us to understand. The wilaya is guardianship. In order to understand guardianship in one word, for example, if you get the letter from the school, it says guardian, signature of the guardians. For the child, there is a guardian. The one who is taking care of that child is a guardian. So Allah is the guardian of the universe. And that guardianship has been given in the hands of the Prophet, and with the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that guardianship came in the hands of Imam Ali. And with the command of Allah, it has been moved to Imam Hassan and reached to Imam Hussein. The purpose of this guardianship is to safeguard the interest which has been created to guide the humanity without any discrimination. That's why the point of deviation, for example, today's the situation of Muslim Ummah is clearly telling us it has been deviated from the point, that point of Hidayah. Where in the Quran clearly says, no one, man ahya'aha faka'annama ahya'an-nasu jami'a. If you give one life to one person, as if you have given life to entire humanity. If you take away one life without reason, من قتل نفسا بغير نفس فكأنما قتل الناس جميعا. So that 7 billion plus population, if you kill one, as if you have killed all. If you give one life, as if you have given life to all. So someone has to represent that Quranic values, and the representation was in the hands of Mawla Imam Hussain alayhi salatu wasalam. He took charge of that wilaya of the prophets, wilaya of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam, wilaya of Imam Ali and wilaya of Imam Hassan. That's why he is assalamu alayka ya waritha amir al-mu'minina waliyillah. So wilaya belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is one. That is the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why lan tajida li sunnatillahi tabdila. Quran says there shall not be any amendment, because that wilaya belongs to Allah. On the contrary, وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَوْلِيَا. This is very important message for all of us. When it comes to non-believers, they don't have one wilaya. They have lot of wilayas. They have lot of representations. It is unfortunate that it has moved from that direction. Imam Ali, while he was guiding to his sons, Imam Hassan and Imam Hussain, the famous will of Imam Ali, one sentence he says, Oh my sons, Imam, oh Hassan and Hussain, be careful. La tas alaykum bil Quran, alaykum bil Quran. Quran is very important. Take care of the Quran and hold on to Quran. Then he says, La tasbiqukum amalin bihi ghayrikum. It could be possible someone may take care of these laws. They go further than you, because Quran is laws. Once they follow the law, they can go further than even a Muslim ummah. Here is وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا, those who are non-believers. Kafaru is kafir, is non-believers. Those who don't believe the wilaya, they are kafaru. Awliya, they are not wali, they are awliya. There are so many wilayatas are there. At-taghut, taghut is those whoever misguide humanity, they are the taghut. So these parallel things are there. That's why it's a famous poet in greater India and Pakistan, a very famous Iqbal al-Lahori, we call him. He says, Musa wa Fir'aun shabbiru yazid. Indu quwwat az hayat amat padid. One is power of Musa, another is power of Fir'aun. One is power of energy of Hussein, another is Yazid. In the humankind, these two energies are there. One is positive energy, another is the negative energy. There's a clash of these two is there. Indu quwwat az hayat amat padi. This is a part of life. Zinda haq az quwwate shabbiri ast. He says, because Imam Hussain, wilaya belongs to wilayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is a truth. It is a haq. And it will remain forever. He never says, zinda haq az quwwate musawi ast. Hazrat Musa, yes, he has done job, he has gone. The protection of the wilaya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hands of Imam Hussain, not only in Karbala, beyond Karbala. That's why some of the scholars, they say, when it comes to the Islamic foundation, and Al-Islam Nabiyul Huduth, it's a very beautiful expression. Al-Islam Nabiyul Huduth, Islam has brought up by the Prophet Adam till the Khatam, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Well, Husainiul Baqa, it remains because of Imam Hussain. That energy to protect, nothing can protect but the wilaya of Imam Hussain. That's why we see the before Muharram, we start get ready for that, to listen to the greatest tragedy of Karbala, which has changed the course of history of humankind and brought humankind towards the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the wilaya we are talking about. I hope all of us, we do understand when we say Ashhadu anna Amir al-Mu'minina waliyillah. First of all, I ask all of you, when we recite ziyarat, we have ziyarat means visit. We have to visit Imam Hussain, even though we are far, as if we are visiting Imam Hussain, because they are the masters of the malakut. They are here, they are there. They are not confined to Karbala. They are every, that energy is everywhere. So once we understand this, when we say ziyarah, don't say I am far from Imam Hussain. That's the hadith we have. من زارنا عارفا بحقنا وجبت له الجنة. The one who does ziyarat of us, provided he is aware of our rights. So that means he understands the salat, he understands the saum, he understands the usul and furu of Islam. Then for him, Jannah is wajib. It is farz upon him. That is the hadith of the Masumi. Here is Ashhadu anna Amir al-Mu'mineen. When we say Amir al-Mu'mineen, same wilaya comes to Imam Hussain. Assalamu alayka ya waritha Amir al-Mu'mineen waliyillah. So Amir al-Mu'mineen, Ali also wali Allah, and Imam Hussain also wali Allah. Why they are wali Allah? They are the protectors of the Islamic the path. That's why we have, when we say اهدنا صراط المستقيم نحن صراط المستقيم, hadith says from the Masumin, we are the path which leads to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That virasa which belongs to Allah has been given to the Prophet, it has been given to Imam Ali, it has been given Imam Hassan to Imam Hussain to protect the religion which has been brought up the Prophet, and in order to take this Islam until the last moment, Imam Hussain took charge, and he has gone through tremendous pain and miseries in order to safeguard the interests of Allah. That's the last moment of his very famous, we have verses, he says, تَرَكْتُ الْخَلْقَ تُرًّا فِي حَوَاكَ وَأَيْتَمْتُ الْأَيَالِي لَكَيْ أَرَاكَ. Wallah, I am leaving everything. Why I am leaving everything? I am in love with you. That is the wilaya. I am in love with you, even though now, very soon, my kids will be orphans. Why I am doing so? In order to meet you. That is the guidance from Karbala. That is the guidance from the Ziyaratul Waritha. I hope those who are listening, don't only recite Ziyaratul Waritha as a ziyarat, as if you are meeting Imam and saying salam in front of Imam and committing your pledge of allegiance by saying, oh Imam, I will be follower of you. That means I will be offering namaz on time. I will be doing psalm. I will be doing zakat and qums. I will be faithful to your guidance. That is the meaning of virasat of Imam Ali alayhi salatu wasalam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi.